It's that time of year again, the time where we talk about what fantastic DAI mods I found to enhance our games. The ones that I have for you today are definitely more on the indulgent side instead of gameplay, but honestly, when I start my next playthrough, I couldn't imagine not having these in my load order. These are all Frosty mods, and if you have any trouble using Frosty, I have a tutorial for how to use that mod manager, as well as how to use Frosty with the .dai mods, and I'll leave a link in the description for both of those. Now, first up, I have for you a mod called Regal Inquisition Throne. Honestly, this mod is a gift. I love how much of a statement this throne makes while also adding that visual weight behind what you're doing as Inquisitor while you're sitting on that throne. I also love that it's not over the top affiliated with any one group, as it just has the Inquisition symbol at the top, so it can really help develop whatever role-playing narrative that you have for your character. This throne does replace the Inquisition throne, so it'll be the first throne that you see in actually a slightly different state when you arrive at Skyhold. Custom beds were recently the thing for Dragon Age Inquisition modding, and I'm not even sorry about it because, oh my gosh, these beds are absolutely gorgeous. I have two different ones for you today, and these are bed replacers, and the description for each of the mods will tell you which bed that they replace, and I cannot even begin to tell you how much I suggest you check these out and possibly try them in your game, as they're a fun addition to a game that most of us have played a lot, and they're also going to help you tell kind of a new narrative story behind your Inquisitor, or maybe enhance it. Plus, if you have a romance option that's going to have cutscenes in your room, it can make that scene itself feel a little bit more new and a little bit more fresh. This floral overhaul is absolutely incredible. If you're like me and have put in a stupid amount of time into this game, you know that the landscape can start to have that been there, seen that vibe to it. And this mod helps to eliminate that feeling a bit while also just being stunning and really well made. I find myself wanting to go and see what's over there on that side of the map again, or I just want to walk around the Emerald Graves or the Hinterlands or anything like that because it just all looks so pretty and fresh. This mod does change the flowers to have a more purple tone to them. The fall birch and orange toned bushes have been retextured to be lilac bushes and purple toned flower trees, and daisies have been added to the grass. So all of that is going to carry over into any part of the game or any zone of the game that would have these in them. So if you're somebody that is definitely looking for a fun, fresh, and gorgeous floral overhaul in Dragon Age, this would be the one to download. When one of your favorite modders of all time decides to convert the Triss Marigold DLC outfit from The Witcher 3 into Dragon Age Inquisition, you must feature it in your mod video. I mean, that's not really a law, but it is a law now that I am making it one. This conversion for the outfit is absolutely gorgeous, and it is for human female Inquisitors only. It does replace the light armor from the Spoils of the Canary DLC, so that is a requirement for it. Overall, if you are looking for a stunning, dramatic outfit for your Inquisitor, I mean, you don't look any further, just go download this. Mythal Statues Remade is another mod that very much helps give the game a fresher, new feeling to it, especially like I said earlier, if you're somebody that's put in a lot of time to this game in the past. The statue itself is beautifully done and elevates Mythal in some ways with how elegant the statue is. She really does feel like someone who is revered and, you know, had an entire temple dedicated to her that you get to go visit. It's dramatic, it's stunning, and it does work in both Trespasser as well as the base game, so you can have this consistently throughout the course of your game and is something to heavily consider downloading if you'd like something new. No Glow or Shimmer Effects is the mod I've waited for since literally I started playing this game. I've personally never been a fan of the glowing, let's light you up like a Christmas tree effect that the regeneration and quick heal potions can give you. It's distracting and very much pulls me out of the immersion of role-playing my character. Plus, I was never into how it stuck on you in cutscenes as well. So now with this mod, I don't have to worry about it anymore as it removes it altogether. There is an option to just remove it for quick heal, just for the regeneration potion, or both, and I'm going to suggest both just because it is delightful. But if you too hate that glowy, shimmery effect, make sure you go ahead and download this mod. And that's it. Those are some of my favorite mods for DAI in 2021. Thank you all so much for joining me, and happy modding.